Welcome to Raj Sabha team. You're watching a special show on Parliamentary Standing Committee. I'm Amritanshu Rai. In this show, we bring to you in-depth coverage of recommendations made by the Parliamentary Standing Committee on the functioning of ministries and their departments. Today, we will talk about the Standing Committee report on food and consumer affairs. The Standing Committee on Food and Consumer Affairs has pulled up the government for not providing sufficient mechanism to create awareness among consumers about their rights. The committee has also asked the government to give suo motu powers to consumer courts.
The Standing Committee on Food and Consumer Affairs finds that most of the consumers are unaware of their rights under Consumer Protection Act. In its 25th report on the Consumer Protection Amendment Bill, the committee has sought suo motu powers to consumer courts to take action against manufacturers who undercut consumers.
See, if you have to make the tribunals effective, you have to give them teeth and nail. The present tribunals don't have any penal powers. They cannot penalize anybody. Therefore, they become only academic platform. And such platforms don't work on the national basis.
I'm in favor of suo motu power to tribunal because this too much decentralization won't help, especially in the consumer's problem. Because every day we have come across the many complaints we are having, food or other items. So the suo motu power should be given to tribunal.
Listening to the problems with the proposed bill, the committee says it lacks clarity on jurisdiction of state and central level forums. Other shortcomings include a growing backlog of cases, lack of infrastructure at consumer forums, and technicalities in proceedings that consumers can't understand. The National Consumer Protection Forum disposed 4,219 cases out of 5,099 in 2011. In 2012, it could dispose only 1,016 out of 1,585 cases. Among the state commissions, the Andhra Pradesh Commission stood last, disposing only 11 cases out of 288 in 2012.
I know my right, but I don't know how to go for the redressal.
Yes.
So that redressal, that also committee has suggested that the redressal mechanism also should be easy and consumer friendly.
Okay.
Then only consumers will go to it.
More and more cases of service industry are landing up, which are not ordinary cases of a good case where you can immediately see this is defective and you replace it. It requires a hearing of like a case. Case is filed, advocates are appointed, and then it is interpretation of contract.
The Standing Committee felt that authorities didn't check quality of goods and services before allowing them into the market. It has asked the government to take necessary steps in this regard, while also recommending standardized goods and services. The committee has also suggested improvements in the laboratory infrastructure in line with the international standards and more powers for consumer forums to grant punitive damages. It has also asked the centre to share at least 30% of salaries of presidents, members and staff of state-level consumer forums. The committee has suggested that department be told to issue directions to all manufacturing entities to set up a complaint handling cell with a deadline to resolve cases.
Many viewers will also know the experience that you lodge a complaint, then you fight with the manufacturer or the dealer, whatever the case may be, and then finally the dealer or manufacturer is found guilty. In that case, the levy, the fine is so low, as bad as 100 rupees or 1,000 rupees, then it is of no meaning.
Madam, the judicial forum is the main authority. It is a supreme authority. Court is a supreme authority. Consumer forum and tribunals are all separate body. Even though it is having the power, it is a separate body. The court is the only the highest forum.
So those cases, these consumer forums ultimately turn into court, and court like hearings go on. And in any court-like hearing, when cases are more and forums are less or judges are less, then delay is bound to occur.
Committee noted that neither the State and District Consumer Forum maintain data of pending cases, nor do they adhere to the 90-day time limit to dispose cases. It has asked the government to not only strengthen monitoring systems, but also critically appraise progress reports sent by the state and union territories. The panel wants defaulting states to take remedial steps and make Consumer Forum adhere to their time schedule. It has sought inclusion of a clause to make timely disposal of cases mandatory and to create a mediation center to clear pending complaints.
The committee has suggested to the government to give suo motu powers to consumer courts. To tell us more on this issue, I am joined by my colleague Raj Kamal Rao. Raj, what has the committee suggested relating to giving suo motu powers to consumer courts?
See, committee actually suggested the government to give suo motu powers to consumer forums in cases of food adulteration, because a person's life is put at risk and the manufacturing companies, especially those who manufacture packed food, do not interact with the customers and they don't have any consumer redressal forums. By giving suo motu powers, committee is actually addressing a common man's issue.
We spoke to the chairman standing committee, Mr. Babu Rao Mutemwar, and began by asking him how the government had failed to create awareness among consumers.
ये consumer protection bill जो हमारे सामने पहले चल रहा था, और आपको मालूम है कि आज सारे दुनिया की नज़र अगर हमारे देश के तरफ है तो हमारा बहुत बड़ा consumer market है। देश तो बाद में आएंगे, लेकिन हमारा population इतना बड़ा है कि हमारा खुद का consumer market इतना बड़ा है, उसी पर चल रहा है। विदेशी तो आते नहीं हमारे देश में खरीदने के लिए, हमारा ही consumer market बड़ा है। अब जब इतना बड़ा कंज्यूमर मार्केट है, लोअर मिडिल क्लास था वो अपर हुआ, अपर मिडिल क्लास अब सुपर हुआ, आज गांव में भी मनरेगा के वजह से पैसे जा रहे, लोगों के पास पैसा आया तो खरीदना चाहते, खाना चाहते, तो फिर उनको वही जो पुराना ढर्रा है कि कोई देखे नहीं, बिल में लिखा नहीं है, कोई भी गलत माल दे रहा है और वो खरीदते रहे, ये सारे चीज़ों को, जैसे अब मेरे साथ हुआ और मैं दौड़ रहा हूँ कंज्यूमर फोरम के पास, दैट शुड नॉट बी देयर। That needs the awareness. That needs the proactive role from the consumer affairs ministry. तो हमने उनको कहा कि सिर्फ आप ये जागो जागो, ग्राहक जागो, और फिर कहाँ भागो? मैंने ऐसा बोला, दैट इज माई वर्शन, कहाँ भागो? फिर आपको ढूंढते रहेंगे, ये वेर इज द कोर्ट, वेर इज द पीपल। आप ये इतने लोगों को लेकर ये लॉ को इम्प्लीमेंट नहीं कर सकते, और आपका जो उद्देश्य है ग्राहकों को संरक्षण देना, ये संरक्षण नहीं है, ये निरीक्षण है। सिर्फ हमने उनसे कहा और आपको ये बनाना पड़ेगा, तंदुरुस्त बनाना पड़ेगा। अब जैसे ग्राहक संरक्षण कोर्ट है, उसकी अपॉइंटमेंट नहीं है। अच्छा, वो राज्य सरकारों की तरफ है, राज्य सरकार अपनी लहर की तरफ करती है, उनको भी कोई चिंता नहीं है, उनके पास पैसे भी नहीं है। हमने कहा कि तुम प्रोएक्टिव करो, आप दीजिए, वो हमने इंक्लूड करने को लगाया, फिर भी राज्य सरकारों के पास नहीं है। जैसे क्या है कि ये लॉ मैंडेटरी होना चाहिए, कोई भी चीज़ मैंडेटरी होना चाहिए। अच्छा, दूसरी बात कैसा है कि लोगों को डर तो लगना चाहिए। अभी उसके अंदर जो ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा दंड की प्रोविजन थी वो 5 लाख थी। हमने बोले साहब, जैसे अगर वीडियो कान या कोई भी टीवी है उन्होंने लिया, उस वो फंसा गया, 50 लाख भी अगर उनको ये करेंगे आप, तो दैट इज़ अ वेरी स्मॉल अमाउंट फॉर हिम। वो तो कोई भी CEO को लगा देंगे और वो 50 लाख रुपये भर के और अपना काम करेगा। तो मतलब ये ऐसा नहीं चलेगा। हम जब अपने देश को सुपर पावर बनाना चाहते तो ये क्रेडिबिलिटी हमारी बनना चाहिए कि अपना ग्राहक तो हमारे माल पे विश्वास रखे, ये सही माल है करके। तो ये बोला, ये जो एक साधारण अपेक्षा ग्राहक की है मैन्युफैक्चरर लोगों से, और इसी को नियंत्रण करने का काम होता, हमारा अवेयरनेस कैंपेन होना चाहिए, हमारे ये जो स्क्वाड है वो जो सरप्राइज चेकिंग वाले वो होना चाहिए। तो आपने वो कंप्लेंट आने के पहले आपने देखना चाहिए, जैसे अभी तेल की एडवर्टाइजमेंट आती कि आप अगर गंजे हो तो आप ये तेल लगाइए 1 महीने के अंदर 2 महीने के लिए, और मतलब धड़ल्ले से लोग ले रहे हैं। मैंने बोला, कोई अगर सावला आदमी है तो उसको कोई तो भी क्रीम की एडवर्टाइजमेंट आती है कि तो आप एक लगाइए और आप गोरे हो जाएंगे। तो मैंने बोला, ये आप टेक्नोलॉजी जो है या तो हमारा साइंस जो है उनसे बात करिए कैसा हो सकता है। उन्होंने कह दिया कि ऐसा नहीं हो सकता। उसके बाद भी लोग बेचेंगे तो मतलब ये लॉ का क्या उपयोग होगा? तो लॉ शुड बी स्ट्रेंजेंट, लोगों को डर तो लगे कि ये लॉ है भाई, मैं इस पर नहीं करूंगा, तो आप ऐसा लॉ बनाइए। ये हमारे रिकमेंडेशन थे उसको।
स्थायी समिति ने जागो ग्राहक और ग्राहक को जागरूक करने के जो गवर्नमेंट के जो प्रस्ताव है उस पर थोड़ा कामयाब पाई है। स्थायी समिति की क्या आलोचना है इसको पूरे देश भर इसको प्रचारित करने के लिए?
बार कोड सिस्टम, जैसे हमने कहा कि मॉल में तो अभी लगे, कुछ दुकानदार भी लगा रहे, उसमें होता कैसे, जैसे आप साड़ी के दुकान में गए आप, तो साड़ी के दुकान में वहाँ कोई रेट नहीं लिखा रहता, लिखा भी रहता है तो वो कोड में लिखा रहता है, यानी कोड वो दुकानदार का, जैसे अभी 5,000 की साड़ी होंगी तो उसका वो कोड रहता है ABCD, यानी वो उनके लिए ये वो बोलता 5,000 रुपये की। हमने उनसे पूछा भाई ये इसके 5,000 तूने कैसा बताया, नहीं बोले साहब आप ये बता दो। अच्छा, इसका कोई उनके पास लेखा जोखा नहीं रहता, यानी वो सेल टैक्स को फंसाते, वो इनकम टैक्स को फंसाते। हमने बोलिए कब तक चलेगा, जो हमारा ग्राहक आज खरीदारी करना चाहता है और वो लगातार उसको फंसाते रहे, ये बरोबर नहीं होगा। इसलिए हमने बोला कि ये दुकान में कितना है वो बार कोड अगर लगा देवे तो ये उसकी सख्ती करिए आप, जब आपके पास टेक्नोलॉजी आई है। अच्छा, एक जगह अगर बार कोड का उपयोग हो रहा है, मॉल में हो रहा है, दूसरे दुकानों में होना शुरू हो गया, तो वाई नॉट एवरीवेयर।
आपने बार कोड सिस्टम को हर एक दुकान पर रखने की मांग की है, क्या एग्जिस्टिंग हमारे पास वो टेक्नोलॉजी है, क्या वो मशीनरी है?
ये तो इसी कड़ी में है ना, अनफेयर प्रैक्टिस करेंगे उनके लिए कोई भी नहीं होगा, उनके लिए तो कोई बंधन ही नहीं है। मेरा ऐसा कहने का मतलब है कि लोगों को डर रहे, जो माल बेचता है वो जिम्मेदारी के साथ बेचे। अब वो जिम्मेदारी के साथ बेचे ये तो स्वाभाविक हमारी अपेक्षा है, लेकिन वो नहीं करता और वो इसी तरह से ये सारी योजनाओं को एक्सप्लॉइट करता, लोगों को फंसा रहता, ये बरोबर नहीं है। और मैंने उनसे कहा कई मुद्दों पर, मैंने उनसे कहा देखो आजकल तो हम जो अपने घरों को या तो दुकानों को ताला इसलिए लगाते हैं कि ईमानदार आदमी की नीयत खराब ना हो, चोर लुटेरा हो तो वैसे तुम्हारा ताला और तिजोरी तोड़ के ले जाता है। तो अभी ये हमारा अप्रोच होना चाहिए कि भाई कोई भी ऐसी हिम्मत ना करे। अब वो हमारे देश में, अब जैसे सिंगापुर में एडल्ट्रेशन के लिए फांसी लगाते, और वो भी कह के फांसी लगाते, बोल के फांसी लगाते, और सार्वजनिक फांसी लगाने का कार्यक्रम होता है, लोगों के दिल में डर होता है। अब हम गांधीवादी देश है, उतना तो ना हो, लेकिन इसका मतलब तो ये नहीं कि हम कायदे ऐसे बनावे कि लोगों को दुख ना हो और लोग लूटते रहे हमारे को। तो हमने उनसे बार बार कहा कि कायदे बनाइए आप, बिकॉज इट इज़ इन द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द कंट्री, ज़्यादा लोगों के हित में जो चीज़ होती है और उसमें अगर कुछ लोगों को दुख होता है तो वो करिए आप, उसमें सरकार ने पीछे नहीं हटना चाहिए, उसी का नाम सरकार है।
It's time for us to take a break. When we return, we will tell you about the committee's recommendation relating to e-marketing and telemarketing. Welcome back. The Standing Committee has asked the government to create a mechanism to register complaints relating to telemarketing and e-marketing. The committee feels that the consumers are often taken for a ride in such transactions.
The Standing Committee on Food and Consumer Affairs has found that shopkeepers exploit customers by compelling them to buy goods merely on faith, while refusing to take them back. It expressed concern over the purchase done through e-commerce and telemarketing, where sellers totally lack accountability and responsibility.
Online complaints of late are appearing, like Naptol we got a complaint, that man had difficulty in even approaching this forum. He first approached Jago Gahak Jago, and they also gave him some information, but it was not complete. And ultimately, again he is finding it how to get them served, because they only provide some numbers, telephone numbers. And on telephone numbers, when he contacts, he finds none.
The committee has suggested provisions to enable consumers to file complaints online with fees. The report says that government should take immediate action against shopkeepers who don't print the minimum retail price. The committee has also asked the government to put in place mandatory barcode system and an unfair trade practice authority to punish guilty shopkeepers, manufacturers and advertisers. The committee recommends reduction of role of advocates since most cases don't involve complex legal interpretation, and also a provision to allow consumers to file class action suits to cover complaints of a wide spectrum of affected consumers.
And ultimately, these cases, though the procedurally they become very technical court-like thing, but at the bottom line is a complaint. There is something that man has to say, other man is able to defend or not. So it should be heard in that summary manner. Even if it has taken shape of a suit or a civil case, but because of advocates, it is not so easily done. But while disposing it off, it should be taken in a very summarily manner, yes. And not much importance is to be given to a small technicalities raised in appeal.
The Standing Committee feels the future of consumer protection will depend on the cooperation between center and state level governments, which is why it wants ministry to effectively implement consumer related programs and policies in close coordination with the states.
Many places, when we fight with the multinational companies or big players, is becoming very, very big thing, and for the finding money and other things for the fight is very big thing. So first, government has to help the consumer for fighting for their right.
Is that there should be a campaign so that people at large would know what is their right, how to go about it, how effective this tool is. That's why the committee has suggested several measures, for example, newspaper ads or television ads, then meetings of consumers with regular periodicity. I hope that happens.
The Consumer Protection Act was enacted in 1986. It mandated establishment of quasi-judicial entities at district, state and national levels to provide simpler, low-cost and quicker redressal of consumer grievances. It also introduced the concept of consumer, giving him additional rights since the Act has been facing setbacks ever since its initiation. The government has introduced an amendment bill in the Lok Sabha on 16 December 2011. The Standing Committee submitted its report to the Parliament in December 2012. On this bill. Rajkamal Rao, Rajya Sabha TV.
The committee has expressed concern over the largely unregulated increasing online business and has asked the government to form some sort of a policy relating to it. To tell us more on the issue, I'm joined by my colleague Rajkamal Rao. Raj, what has the committee said in this regard?
See, the proposed Consumer Protection Amendment Bill actually focuses on the frauds relating to e-transactions and telemarketing, where the source of the manufacturer and source of the distributor is unaware and not known to the customer. So in case of a damage is happening or a damage happens to any of the product which is purchased on telemarketing basis, the consumer has no option but to go to a consumer court. Now the government and as well as the Standing Committee wants consumer forums to take stricter action against those frauds which are taken and handled by the e-transactions and the companies who are involved in telemarketing.
We spoke to Mr. Ashim Sanyal, President Consumer Voice, an organization that made a presentation before the Standing Committee, and began by asking him the impact of online transactions on consumers.
You've made your presentation to the Standing Committee on Consumer Affairs. They've already examining the existing act and as well as the recent amendment proposed by the government. So what were your observations on the bill and what were your important recommendations to the committee, sir?
The most critical observation, first of all, let me begin with by saying that this is one of the most articulated document in the Constitution of India, the Consumer Protection Act of 1986. Whoever made this basically ensured that the future is taken care of, and not much of an amendments are required unless the market sees a huge transition. Now, we have seen a market transition in the late 90s and the early 2000s, in fact, and today we have come to a position where certain amendments were required, and therefore we appeared before the Standing Committee to give our recommendation. One of the basic recommendation was the market, looking at the market transition, was basically empowering the courts, in fact, consumer courts, to basically ensure that they have the suo motu powers, because this is one absenteeism that we notice in the market, which is a major loophole which has been taken consumers for a right for a very long time, in fact. And one of the critical avenues of this is that consumer forums do not have the suo motu power. We did recommend that to the Standing Committee, and I'm glad that it has been considered.
Okay, let me ask you about the barcoding system that you have proposed. How does universal barcoding system will help in, whereas in PDS system or in any private, private empowered industries, how is it going to benefit the consumer?
The barcoding system is nothing new. It's not new in India. It's been there under discussion for the last almost 5 years, in fact, and we have been part and parcel discussing the same with food and drug committees. In fact, we have discussed that with all the Standing Committee at various levels for different sections. We believe that barcoding is one way of basically removing duplicate material from the market, in fact. And when we say that it is applicable up to the PDS level, we are basically being inclusive. Okay. We are trying to be inclusive that nobody, whether he's BPL or above the poverty level, nobody is basically getting the spurious material, and barcoding, therefore, as in the case of developed world, has to come in sooner or later.
Okay. So, did the issue of products purchased in good faith, I'm referring to the products purchased on online transactions, so was that a concern for the committee and as well as the representatives who were made their opinions with the standing committee, sir?
I think one of the most elaborate deliberation that we had with the standing committee, and a very healthy one, was regarding online, which was our first recommendation to the standing committee, because we see hordes of complaints coming in because of online transaction. There are black ships, obviously, and there will be always black ships. So we basically, our recommendation was that if you do not cover the online portals right now under the Consumer Protection Act, we will be too late, in fact, in protecting the interests of the consumers. We firmly believe that a law specifically for e-commerce is required separately, in fact, but till then, we should do with a stringent law or measures under the Consumer Protection Act to control basically the dubious dealings of the e-commerce portals.
Okay, my last question, sir, before we conclude, what is your take on the companies that are cheating consumers, and the government has no database? Was the database maintenance an issue before the standing committee while you are representing?
It was not an issue before the standing committee, and we never deliberated on this particular point. But then Consumer Voice has been doing comparative testing in which we rank products good, bad or ugly, in fact. And we do provide that, because this is under grant of Ministry of Consumer Affairs. We do provide the data to the ministry, which easily can be used to name and shame the companies who are basically selling either substandard material or unsafe products. Mm. We believe that this is going to be one of the strongest measures if the government actually does enact this particular law, because self-declaration is become a motto of the companies in terms of, you know, highlighting their own credibility. But when it comes from a third party like Consumer Voice or any other source which is reliable and who basically tells you that the product quality or the brand image is bad, in fact, then the harm done to the companies is going to be enormous, and they're going to be very, very careful in producing such products or goods and services.
Thank you for watching Standing Committee. We'll be back with a new episode and a new show. Keep watching Rajya Sabha TV.